In this video, I'm going to take this notepad window and slap an entire Minecraft onto it. To do this, I'm going to make a notepad engine that allows you to make games in notepad. I will explain how I did this, and along the way, you'll also learn some interesting graphics programming concepts and color theory. So, let's dive right into it. So it all starts with this article. This is where I learned to make my cheat engine clone that I talked about in my previous video. But the article talks about making a game in notepad. The idea is to get access to the memory location where the notepad buffer is and write characters directly to it so it becomes like a screen. So the first thing I had to do was, well, open a notepad process. How hard can it be? After figuring out how to open the notepad instance, I was like, alright, time to send it some keystrokes to fill that nice big screen buffer. Next, I just have to search for these letters in the notepad's memory and write there. Here I stumbled upon my first problem. At the end of each line, I needed to add a new line character, so it would, you know, go to the next line. But it gave me these weird patterns, so I figured that Notepad doesn't just use \n for new lines. And after doing some reverse engineering and looking at the memory of a Notepad instance, it seems like Notepad uses internally a carriage return and a line feed character to symbolize new lines. And after that, I was finally able to display something to the screen. Now, it seems like if you click on the Notepad window, it crashes, so I had to find a way to block the input. Blocking the resize, however, also crashes it completely, so you're just supposed to not do this. No, stop that. If you're curious how all this Windows API stuff works, I will make a window manipulation tutorial soon in my WinAPI tutorial series, so check it out if you're interested. I then tried to figure out the correct notepad dimensions, and after that I had enough to start making it run a game. But how exactly am I going to convert something 3D into the notepad? I came up with the idea to just make the game in OpenGL as normal, and instead of displaying the frame to the screen, I would just convert the image into a grayscale and attribute each region to a letter, depending on the luminosity. I also used the CMake setup template for this engine, that I talked about in this video. And it is the thing that most of my projects use, so this means that it is the same process to develop a notepad game as a normal game. So I just got to work at getting the information from OpenGL and converting it to letters. Now I just have to make it look better. For this, I need more and better letters, and after randomly searching for stuff, as any good programmer would, I found these braille letters that seem promising. So, you know, hippity hoppity, your letters are my property or something. And while I didn't know at the time, they actually also allowed me to later implement a totally different displaying method. They didn't work at first though, and I thought it was because of the letter format. I'm using UTF-8 letters, and that means that they can have 1, 2, 3 or 4 bytes, but in the notepad, they have 2 bytes at least, and some might have more, I think. Yeah, complicated stuff. But no, the bug was in my code, and it was where I was least expecting it. So as a quick advice, don't assume that you know what the problem is whenever you are debugging. Okay, now let's start to port a game inside the engine. If you watch my cross-platform video, you probably remember that I talked about splitting the window stuff and the gameplay stuff into 2 separate components, and have an interface between them. Think of a game logic as the frontend and the window stuff with rendering as input as the backend. Since I started from my framework, the Notepad engine basically has the same interface as many of my other projects. So I can just take a game made by me and replace its backend with the Notepad engine. Before we try 3D, let's start with something simple. I'll use my Steam game because it's the most finished game I have, plus it's pixel art with a limited color palette, so it should be easy. Okay, we are off to a great start. Let's see what the bug is. What? Okay, I have no idea how this didn't crash my program before, but let's try again. I've seen better graphics. Maybe a 3D game will look better. So now it is the moment that you all have been waiting for. I have multiple Minecraft clones, so I will just replace the backend of one of them. After fixing all the compile errors, I got this. It looks promising, but now we need to make it look better. There are 2 problems that we have to solve, and the first one is that I'm trying to take a big resolution image and scale it into a lower resolution image. Right now, for each letter in the output notepad image, I'm sampling a pixel from the original image. This is called nearest sampling, and it is not that good because I'm basically throwing some valuable image information away. Imagine that I took the notepad result and placed it on top of the original image. What if, for each letter, I sample all the pixels that fall under it and average their luminosity? This is called linear sampling, and you can already see that the result looks more consistent. Looking at the braille characters, however, I came up with a totally different idea. Each braille character seems to have 2x4 dots in every configuration possible. Look again at this image. What if for each notepad letter, I look at 2x4 pixels in the original image and chose the exact matching braille letter? For example, this zoomed in portion of the game maps to one letter. If I put a 2x4 grid over it and look at the luminosity value for each cell, I would get this pattern that I can map directly to a braille letter. This allows me to essentially increase the resolution of my pixels at the expense of having multiple shades of grey, because now I just have black or white. The problem is that there are 8 dots in each letter, and 2 to the 8th power means 256 combinations of letters that I couldn't just fill by hand. So I did what any good programmer would do and asked ChatGPT to fill them out for me. He didn't do quite just that, but instead told me that each dot maps to 1 byte. So using that knowledge, I figured out the mapping pattern, and I don't know what the guys who created it smoked, but it is this, and this is the final result. Now, this lacks color range, but I can take the linear sampling version and put it on top in a checker pattern to get this result that already looks very nice. This effect is called dithering in computer graphics, and it allows you to achieve more color information than colors available. The second problem is that I have a limited choice of gray letters and I can't increase it. These are all the symbols that I have, and that's it. What I can do instead is to use them as efficient as possible. Let me show you something. This is a Minecraft screenshot. Let's apply a gray filter over it. It looks terrible. We need to apply another filter over it, so it looks more, let's say, dramatic. Now this looks more playable. The first step in code is to apply the simple gray filter, and if you think that just means averaging the red, green and blue channel, you are wrong. Cool kids use this dot product formula. Now this looks scary, but it is actually just a weighted average, and it is because our eyes perceive each primary color with a different light intensity, with green being the most intense and blue the least. It is probably because we evolved to better see stuff in nature and things are green more often than blue. But after that, I also wanted to apply this curves effect, so I just opened Desmos and figured out the right formula for the job. If you don't understand how this graphics translates to color, I want to make a mess for game dev video in the future, so subscribe to not miss that out. Finally, after applying all of these things, I can show you the result. Now, there are definitely improvements that can be made. Changing the in-game textures, for example, to get a better final result. Input also has some problems, so if you want to see part 2 of this video where I make the Notepad engine fully functional, smash the subscribe and share button. Until then, if you would also want to learn these things, don't forget about the new Windows API tutorials that I'm doing. Finally, if you like this video and would like to support me, share it so it takes over the world, and you can also wishlist my game on Steam or join my channel. Thanks!